Hello my dear students, today we are going to study a poem which is related to you all, yes, the children. See, children are going to school. The poem's name is Children Are Going to School. Just tell me, what is the feeling of your parents when they are sending you to school? For example, when you are very small, young, you are going first time for the nursery classes or junior KG, the parents are very happy. Yes, why? Because their children are going to be learned men, padhe likhe hone wale hain, they are going to be literate person and they get the knowledge and they are going to help in the nation building. So every parent has a dream that their child studies well and do good in their future. So our poem is Children Are Going to School. Take out your textbook and, as I always say, move your fingers accordingly so that it would be easy for you all to understand. 1.4 Children are going to school. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again the sky bows his head in respect, for children are going to school. So in the first paragraph it has been said that all are very much happy because the children are going to school. So here the natural elements like the sun, the sky, they all are showing human qualities. For example, it's early morning, the sun is rising and the sky bows his head in respect. The sky is bowing his head. Tell me, can the sky really bow his head? No, it has just been given a human quality. The sun after his morning dip in the river. Now it has been said about the sun. Early morning, how is the sun? What is the color of the sun? Full yellow color. Dressed up in his golden muslin turban. So yellowish and golden color. And muslin is a type of a cloth. Waits and smiles on one side of the road for children are going to school. So in the second paragraph, the son is very happy. Yes, and that why it is happy because the children are going to school. Through the green crop branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Now as the children are going to school, the breezes, hawa, they are all singing the songs of blessings, ashirvad. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with the melodies, and the flowers, they are very, the smell is very good, the fragrance is very nice. At the corner of a lane, the people in his lush green foliage waves his hand for children are going to school. So people tree, aapko to maloom hi rahega, people ka jhaad, so it's very green, everywhere it's green, lush green foliage means green, green color everywhere, greenery. Angels of light have set out, every road is a gleam. All the roads which are there, they are shining. At this hour, every particle of earth throbs like a mother's heart. Jo bhi hai raste mein, sab maa ke dil ke jaise dhadak rahe hai. Throbs, beats. Time sitting on an old roof, flies pigeon in the sky. For children are going to school. So pigeons are flying, time is sitting on the roof and all are just seeing the children, they are going to school and everybody is very happy because children are going to school. Just tell me children, what will happen if children are not going to school? Un log school hi nahi ja rahe, un log padhai nahi kar rahe, what will happen? Yes, they will not have manners, they will not know how to speak, they will not know how to count. So what will happen? Anybody can fool them. So that is why education is very much necessary for every child. Koi bhi bachcha bina padhe rehna nahi chahiye, sab log padhna chahiye. Is this poem clear? This poem is telling that the whole universe is happy because children are going to school. Now tell me, what all things our parents do when we as children go to school? Hamare mummy daddy kya karte? Yes, they pay the fees. Then they give us tasty dishes to eat. When we are coming to school, they cover our books, they teach us, they do a lot of hard work. Yes? So we as children, what are we supposed to do in return? We should study properly and we should be a good human being. Yes, children, is this poem clear? I'll give some opposites and some figures of speech. Now, what are antonyms? Right, opposites. Smiles, frowns, respect, disrespect, deep, shallow, light, dark. Yes, smile means hasna, bura lagna, udas, frown. So rest all, I guess we know the meanings. Then come to figures of speech. The sky bows his head in respect. Now children, tell me, can the sky really bow his head like us? No, it is just given a human quality. So this is personification. Sky is given human quality of bowing. Yes, children, did you understand what is personification? Non-living things are given the human qualities. Human beings ka quality diya gaya. Now we as human beings can go ahead. Sky kar sakta hai kya? No. So similarly, some more personification examples are there. Try to find out. Then every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Here there is a direct comparison hua hai. Every particle of the earth ke koi bhi particle kisse directly compare kiya hai? Mother's ke heart ke saath. So this is simile, direct comparison. Yes, children, clear? One more I give. Breezes sing their songs of blessings. Now, one thing is there that really breezes can do. Bless kar sakte hai kya? No. So it is personification. One more figure of speech is alliteration. Now, what is alliteration? Sounds are repeated. So we can understand understand that in poem, the poet uses such figures of speech to give more poetic effect. Poem को और बेहतरीन बनाने के लिए poet जो है ऐसे ऐसे words use करते हैं या ऐसे ऐसे figures of speech use करते हैं, जैसे non living things को living thing का quality बताना, direct comparison करना या indirect comparison करना या similar sounds को repeat कराना. क्यों? Because to give more poetic effect. So we studied simile, personification and alliteration. Yes, children? Thank you.